الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our gathering, Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst the people of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us Laylatul Qadr, Allahumma ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And still at the beginning of every session, we give this mashallah. People are talking with one another. And inshallah, we will make tonight's lecture very short. And we will try inshallah to go directly to the topic of Jannah, the home of the kings and the queens. May Allah let us all enter Jannah al Firdaus. Say Ameen. Allahu Akbar. MashaAllah. One more time, say Ameen. I want to thank Brother Farooq for the great work that he did this year. Thank you, brother. Thank you for you and your family. May Allah bless you. Allahumma ameen. And that's not advertising for your restaurant, which is carry off test on US 19. Just 20% for the imam, okay? Just 20% for the imam, okay? No problem. Jazakallah khair. It's a quick deal here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. It's a great time to be here as a family. You know what, as an imam, maybe I didn't talk to you before about what Ramadan represents to the imam. It represents almost everything in his career, in his life. The people gathering, love, mercy, passionate, and also the family sense. Alhamdulillah, we are sitting here as one family. And no difference between any one of us. And we are gathered here for the sake of Allah. And we try to, alhamdulillah, to make that iftar to happen for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless us all. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Okay, who needs to hear about Jannah today? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Who is thrilling to Jannah? Who is, you know, very, very eager to get to Jannah? You know what? The companions wouldn't wait to make it to Jannah. You know, the people of Jannah, yes, they will be together and they will be as families together. We talked about the palaces of Jannah. We talked about the rivers of Jannah. We talked about, you know, seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah. We talked about almost everything in Jannah, the gates of the palace of Jannah, even the fruits of Jannah. We talked about the flowers of Jannah. And I wanted to talk to you today about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. May Allah gather us with the Prophet Muhammad in Jannah al-Firdaus. Allahu Akbar. Say Ameen. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. You know what? Where is Rasulullah in Jannah? You know? What's the level of Rasulullah in Jannah? He's in the highest, right? Number one. It's called Al-Firdaus Al-A'la. The highest levels of Jannah, it is called Firdaus. You know what's the meaning of Firdaus? The beautiful decorated gardens. Imagine, just I wanted you to think about this point. What Allah had prepared for His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Jannah. If it is regular Jannah for the rest of the regular people, so what Allah had prepared for Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Jannah. Rasulullah, as we said, will be the first one to enter Jannah. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will come to the gates of Jannah and he will knock the doors of Jannah. Ridwan will answer and he will say, who is knocking? He will say, Muhammad. Then he would say, Allah has commanded me not to open for anyone except you. So please, sisters in the back, just we want it. It's only 5 minutes remain. Just inshallah, try your best to be quiet for 5 minutes. I know it's very hard, But inshallah, Allah will make it easy, inshallah. You know what? Psychologically, the scholar said, do not ask women to keep quiet. Otherwise, you will be in trouble. So let me ask my sisters, am I in trouble tonight? Yes? Okay, astaghfirullah. See, where are the brothers? Your imam in trouble. Subhanallah. Okay, so I wanted just to tell you, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be with the companions. And the companions will be with Rasulullah in Jannah, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam getting the most high and the peak status in Jannah. He has his own river. Do you know that? What's the name of the river of Rasulullah? Al-Kawthar. Allahu Akbar. You memorize. Inna a'tainaka al-Kawthar. Rasulullah is owning a river named after him or named after al-Kawthar, and it is by his name. So he has the title. Where is the title? The Quran. Allah said, Inna a'tainaka al-Kawthar. فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَنْحَمْ إِنَّ شَانِيَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرِ. May Allah gather us with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imagine Jannah has Rasulullah. Imagine you walk and you leave your palace, and while you are walking in the gardens of Jannah, all of a sudden you meet with Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Can you tell me the dunya and what it contains, how much it worth just to get 1 minute to see Rasulullah Muhammad? That is the best thing that you can have in terms of the companionship in Jannah. May Allah let us be always in Jannah to Firdaus with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I just wanted before the dua, I wanted to give just a very remarkable, you know, mention here tonight. Tonight, the food and the iftar is provided by two brothers. Dr. Naveed Siddiqui, his family is providing the iftar, Sister Gail, and her two children, mashallah, her two sons, and also the entire family of Dr. Siddiqui. Plus, we have Dr. Ahmed Mustafa and his wife and his children. May Allah bless both families, Allahumma ameen, Ya Rabbi al-Alameen, bless all of us, Allahumma ameen. In this particular day, I wanted to make a special dua for Dr. Siddiqui. And you know what? Maybe guys, you don't know what's going behind the scene. But as an imam, I'm so proud. Wallahi, I'm so proud to be in a masjid, to be in an Islamic center, which had Dr. Naveed Siddiqui, which has Dr. Rahim, which has Dr. Zaki, which has Dr. Farooq Zaidi, Dr. Mughni, Dr. Shahina, Dr. Muhammad Kaif. You cannot imagine what they are doing behind the scene for everything to be organized. If I say from now to Fajr time, just to thank them for everything that they are doing for the masjid and for the community, my words will not be enough to thank them. May Allah, only Allah, will reward them, inshallah, Jannah al-Firdaus, for everything they are doing, even for the simple things. Wallah, you cannot imagine. It is only by the mercy of Allah. Let's make dua for all of them. May Allah accept our du'as. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. اللهم يا ربنا نسألك في هذه الساعة أن تتقبل صيامنا وصلاتنا وركوعنا وسجودنا. اللهم اختم بالباقيات الصالحات أعمالنا. اللهم ارحم أخينا نبيك صديقي. اللهم ارحم أخينا نبيك صديقي يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم أختنا أفسل يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم ابننا روحان. اللهم اشملهم بعفوك وكرمك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. وتقبل اللهم صيامنا وصلاتنا وركوعنا. اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر. اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر. اللهم بلغنا ليلة القدر. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
الله أكبر. الله
this coming Sunday, 5:30 p.m. We hope you'll all attend. It'll be a lot of fun for kids, adults, everyone of all ages. There'll be, you know, face painting, cotton candy, you know, everything that bounce up for the kids, entertainment for the adults, great food, inshallah. But please make sure that you get the tickets ASAP. Less than a week away at this point. So, inshallah, there's multiple ways of getting the tickets. My mother, Shania Javid, is handling that. There's Venmo with Asila, my wife. There's Zelle with Ruby, Alam. Men can let me know, or Faisal, or anyone. Inshallah, we're planning on making it a good one this year to get the community together, make it a good ending for the month of Ramadan, inshallah. Jazakallah khair.